retailer landscape is now driven by the insistent demand for free shipping, reveals a global study commissioned by UPS. Well, who doesn't like free shipping along with your online purchases? Joining me here in the studio for more is Chris Buono, UPS Philippines Managing Director. Good to see you here, Chris, and welcome to the program.
Afternoon, Kathy. Thank you for having me.
Congratulations on your first year. Wasn't it the first year, same time last year, that you were appointed to the post?
Yeah, April 2017.
So how's it going so far?
So far, not too bad. We're seeing some growth in our country, and that's fueled by definitely the growth in the economy in the Philippines. And, you know, UPS is looking at connecting local UPS companies to the rest of the world. That's part of our growth strategy.
And you have commissioned a global study to evaluate the consumer shopping habits, and this includes pre-purchase to post-delivery.
Correct.
What did that reveal?
So the pulse of the online shopper sort of revealed where we took a survey of 3,200 respondents in the region.
This is from the Philippine context.
This actually was China, Hong Kong, and Japan. And we basically found that the respondents, that we saw three different key areas. We saw constants, we saw movers, and we saw emergers. And the constants are, like you said, you know, they want a better customer experience, a better shipping experience. And, you know, and the movers are, you know, more technology, more shopping through the mobile experience. And then emergers are really areas where it's kind of down the road, where we're looking at alternate delivery locations for pickups of parcels that come into the country.
So are you finding a combination of the three here in the Philippines? From the Philippine context, is the survey also applicable?
So I would say from the Philippines perspective, the constants are definitely there. You know, the ongoing customer experience, both for exporters out of the country, as well as consignees for, you know, that are receiving packages into the country, they want that positive customer experience. They're looking, obviously, for a lower price and, you know, ongoing the free shipping. But we are seeing a move towards, you know, some additional technology along the lines with, obviously, with mobile phones being a constant in many people's hands here, that people are doing a lot more shopping online.
So what are they buying? What are they shipping?
So I would say the highest, what they're buying most is apparel, followed by some high-tech stuff. And you're seeing that both from an intra-Asia perspective as well as purchasing from international, either Europe or the U.S. And definitely if they see that there's a lower cost shipping from Europe or the U.S., they may buy from there versus buying, say, even domestically in the Philippines.
Now, how inflation sensitive are those purchases? Because as inflation's now picked up to a more than 5-year high, you'd appreciate a consumer wanting to save a lot more for the stuff that they need versus the discretionary that they might have to ship around.
Yeah, I think they would potentially delay those purchases, but I mean, brand loyalty being what it is, you know, and I guess the human condition of, you know, wanting something now, you know, I think for sure that you're still going to see those trends go up in terms of purchasing things online.
And they become more demanding. They want a lot of things. They want expedited deliveries,
yes.
Customer-centric return policies, all offered as a standard.
And that's driving retailers, you know, to basically either put their go to different marketplaces, you know, or make their in-store experience better for the consumer. Consumers are driving what retailers are doing right now.
And are the e-commerce firms catching on, or are they being left behind by the consumers that are getting really demanding?
No, I think they're catching on, right? You know, obviously, if people aren't purchasing from you, then, you know, your share is going to go down.
So how should they adapt and change and thrive in this kind of scenario? What are you now telling the online customers and clients as well, and those who are powering online purchases?
So typically with shippers, what we want to do is we want to look at, you know, what different networks and what different countries and markets that you want to get into. And UPS would conduct what's called a supply chain map, you know, and look at the different areas that they want to grow in. And ultimately partnering with a company like UPS, where there's different modes of shipping from air freight, ocean freight, to, you know, obviously our express service, you can look to grow in those areas from a 1 to 3 to 5 year perspective.
In terms of smartphone purchases, you've mentioned that smartphone is one of the three. Among them, people buying through the phones.
Mm-hmm.
Are they happier, though, with the kinds of purchasing that they do on the smartphone than they were a couple of years back?
Well, I think it's easier, for sure. But I think one of the challenges that we do see here is that the Philippines is definitely still a cash-driven society. So, you know, one of the things that e-commerce and retailers could do is to see how they can pull in while, you know, there's a very small segment of the market that uses credit cards and even have bank accounts. How do they use that sort of cash on demand to be able to support that, even that online experience, but still offering sort of a cash on delivery area?
And how is it affecting your business? You mentioned some technology upgrades, service upgrades. Mm-hmm. How is this leading you to invest? What you have to in order to keep up?
Well, just like the build, we're looking at our infrastructure all the time. So, you know, obviously our hub and our, you know, where our Browntail airplane flies into every day is within Clark. And with Clark giving, you know, a huge amount of investment over the course of the next few years, you know, it's an area that we're looking to further invest in because it's the key to our network in the Philippines.
So how much of an investment?
We're still figuring that part out, actually. So.
But then is the intention to bring in more UPS planes in?
I think the intention now is to keep what we have at the moment, but exactly how we service, say, Metro Manila, you know, with the macroeconomic issue of traffic that we have today, you know, and looking at, you know, from a operational perspective, every day we're actually making operating plans and figuring out where our customers are at, both from a pickup and delivery, and, you know, looking at advancing those along the way each and every day.
What about for the Visayas and Mindanao areas? Have you figured out how to expedite deliveries there?
It's not about figuring it out. It's an ongoing process for us. It's definitely an area that we have an interest in. And, you know, with partners like Air 21, who we partner with today, you know, we're sure that we can reach those areas effectively.
Now, how many more hires are you going to be need with this kind of expansion? I mean, the investment is still something in the works, mm-hmm. but could there be more hires this year and the next to prepare for the growth?
I hope so. You know, I mean, from an economy perspective, the more people that we can give jobs in the Philippines, the better, right? So, but at this point, from a we're also looking at technology to help make people's jobs go to be better, right? So that you take some of those, you know, those things that don't add value and you create areas for a person to be able to support our internal processes better.
And you're expanding at a time there's trade tensions between the U.S. and China. Mm-hmm. How is this impacting the way deliveries are sent or maybe alternative markets are seen? Because the Philippines is seen as some sort of a haven as the trade war breaks out. What impact would it have on the logistics business for yourself?
Well, I mean, Philippines, you know, operates in 220 countries around and territories around the world. You know, I think from our perspective, we support free trade globally. You know, obviously the tensions between China and the U.S. is, you know, kind of, you know, we don't like to see that, but, you know, obviously we want to support free trade. I think for the Philippines, short and long term, there are some advantages that could be coming. You know, you may see some value-added services move from, you know, some of these other countries into the Philippines. So I think it's actually a great opportunity for the Philippines to expand even further than what they are.
All right, before you go, and I think our viewers would love to know, are you for free shipping?
There's no such thing as free shipping, right? So for consumers,
but that's what they're asking for.
For consumers, it's free, but there ultimately is someone to pay for it. So from a shipper's perspective, you know, if we're a partner with an online retailer here, then ultimately we have to figure out the best way to get those parcels to the customer as effectively as possible.
So it is forthcoming, and it's going to happen amongst the retailers that you speak with.
I don't think that there's. I mean. Some people will offer free shipping for sure, but ultimately somebody has to pay for that shipping. Whether or not it's the consumer or the shipper, that's to be determined by the e-tailer itself.